Hey everyone, welcome back. So in the last video, did a nice little paint job, learned how to do the base coat of white. In this video, we're going to learn how to do a base coat of black. I'm just kidding, we're not going to do another base coat. Instead, we'll be using a black lure though. Alright. Colors we're going to use today, obviously the opaque black, Jacquard opaque black, Jacquard metallic white, Jacquard fluorescent violet, bright orange, then wicked colors, golden yellow. Alright. Also, we're going to be using this really crumpled up glitter ribbon. I tried to get as much of the glitter off as I could. I've clearly missed some. Let's see if this other piece is any better. No. Okay. So, what we'll do. It's a pretty wide little body. This is a pretty narrow ribbon. Let's just kind of hook it around the back hook there. Okay. Back in there you go. Okay. So it's a very, very fine mesh. We're going to drop that pressure down. To like 5 maybe. I'm going to try and get away without reducing the metallic white. Alright. Now, like I mentioned before, very, very light coats. Try and spray it straight on. If you try to go at an angle, it's so fine that it's probably gonna slide underneath. Getting a bit of a silver color. So all I'm going to do is basically take that white, keep going over it over and over again until it goes from the black to the silver, blah, 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 up into a nice white color. So I think what we'll do is maybe fast forward, we'll cut ahead, and then I'll show you the next color. Okay, so I have most of the coats down. It's not quite turning as vibrant white as I wanted to, so what we're going to do is we're going to introduce some wicked colors, wicked white. What I'm hopefully going to get here is by putting a thin coat of the wicked white on top, I'm going to get best of both worlds. So I'm going to start laying down some of that white on top. When I say best of both worlds, I mean that I'm going to get that little bit more vibrancy from the wicked white. but still have some of that metallic come up from underneath. Okay, wicked golden yellow. Just kind of start anywhere at the head here. And take it to about halfway. Set. Next up, bright orange. And all we do is just kind of do the same idea, but a little bit closer to the head. Kind of spray at an angle a little bit to blend into that yellow. Nice and even on top. All right. Give that a quick set. All right. Moment of truth, if I was thin enough my layers, like I always keep telling you. And slow. peel up any of those extra layers. That's the belly. Don't worry about the belly. We'll figure that out after. Huh, just one little thread is stuck here. There we go. Yeah. Let's see if we can get a better look at that. Nice little crackle effect all over. Okay. I'm gonna heat set that again just to make sure. Okay. Scoot those off to the side. And this would be the best way of doing this. Let's turn these around a little bit. Okay. Off to the black. What we'll do is we'll just kind of paint in the head a little bit around the eyes, just for a little bit of definition. So what we have is just again another little, I'm not sure, can you see that okay? Is that coming through? It'll look better after I put some more paint on it. But anyways, yeah, it's just part of like a craw type thing. What we'll do is we'll kind of fold that right around the back here. See how I can do this with a camera in the way. And okay. Fold that down, paint on the stencil, and just kind of see if that's enough. Yeah, going for kind of like a mask there. Alright, so there's that stencil. Now we'll use the other side of that stencil that I cut. So basically, when you cut your stencils, take your time, go through, keep both halves. So, if you can see that tiny little cut right there, I'm going to kind of match that up to the top of the gill plate. Wrap that around. in. Top the gill plate. Bring it around. Just clean up the bottom a little bit there. Okay. So here's where we're at so far. Yes, this was inspired by a penguin. Going back in with the Wicked White, just a little bit on the belly. Alright, in comes that fluorescent violet. I'm not going to do a lot, but I do love contrasting colors. So I think I'll put just a little bit down here in the throat, kind of blend it into the black. I think it'll look good. If not, I'll start over. It always surprises me just how that little tiny blotch of color can sometimes just make all the difference in a lure. I'm gonna get our eyes out. There. Pretty good angle. Get my knife, get my eyes. And now, just as the video is finishing up, the furnace turns off, so that's awesome. Get that eye ready. Oh good, the furnace started back up again. do the other side. Undo you. Undo you. Let's get this tape off. Okay. Get the light around here. Hit the camera a bunch of times. There. Yeah. There. Focus, focus, focus. No focus. Perfect. Okay. Clear coat it is. Thanks. Bye.